How many times have you been told to follow your heart or go with your gut? At some level, this sounds encouraging. You're smarter than you give yourself credit for, and your deepest feelings will never steer you wrong. But more practically, it feels kind of useless. If you're facing a difficult choice or problem, there are plenty of rational ways of solving it. And they all depend not on the organs below your neck, but the big one above it. So why do we hear this kind of advice so often? And how valid is it? Should we base our decisions on concrete facts and logic, or instead rely on intuition? By intuition, we usually mean a sense of knowing something without knowing how, which may seem irrational, even mystical, but actually has a simple evolutionary explanation. Think of your brain as operating on two levels: conscious, everything you're aware of, and unconscious, everything you're not. Although we associate knowing and thinking with consciousness, numerous experiments have shown that our unconscious brains are constantly absorbing and processing far more than we realize, and for good reason. Conscious thought is slower, so if your unconscious notices signs that a predator's nearby, it's safer to feel the urge to run and think about why later than to think first and run too late. What we call intuitions, then, are signals from our unconscious that are strong enough to pick up on but aren't clear and distinct ideas. Of course, modern humans face fewer natural threats than our prehistoric ancestors did, but intuition can be just as important today. In a case made famous by psychologist Gary Klein, a chief firefighter busy tackling a blaze started to feel something was wrong and ordered everyone out of the building moments before it collapsed. Initially, he put his foresight down to a sixth sense. But going over things with Klein, they realized he had been unconsciously putting together clues from the strange behavior of the fire and instinctively concluded the disaster was imminent. This is a dramatic example, but our brains are always working in the background like this, monitoring the environment, identifying patterns, and planning reactions. So clearly, intuition is real and powerful, but is it always right? In the 1970s, Nobel Prize-winning psychologist Daniel Kahneman and his colleagues identified two ways our minds form judgments. What they called System 1, roughly corresponding to unconscious intuition, and System 2, for conscious analysis. To see the difference, try this puzzle. If a bat and a ball together cost $1.10, and the bat costs a dollar more than the ball, how much does the ball cost? Many people quickly answer 10 cents, but it's actually 5 cents. The thing to recognize here is which system your answer came from. If you stopped to work it out, it was System 2. If the answer immediately leapt to mind, it was System 1, which unconsciously swapped the actual problem for an easier one. $1.10 minus a dollar, enabling it to blurt out an answer quickly, effortlessly, and as it happens, incorrectly. While that example may seem trivial, what Kahneman found is that System 1 takes these kinds of shortcuts all the time, making intuition prone to a whole catalog of errors. And once we realize how often we unquestioningly rely on this system, it becomes clear just how much trouble it can get us into. The irony is that intuition evolved like this to help us survive, not only by evading predators, but also by avoiding too much energy-hungry analytical thinking. But we now live in a world where many problems are far more complex and can't be solved without painstaking analysis, meaning intuition frequently leads us astray. And yet, there's good news too. Consider how we learn to ride a bike, play an instrument, read and write. At first, it takes intense concentration, but over time becomes automatic, unconscious, in a word, intuitive, suggesting that System 1's abilities aren't set in stone. Gary Klein's research confirms that this is how true expertise develops. Through experience, we amass a mental library of situations and solutions, allowing our unconscious to recognize patterns faster than our conscious mind ever could. Which is why a veteran doctor can often diagnose a condition at a glance, or a chess grandmaster can instantly see the winning move. This doesn't mean intuition is never wrong. Even experts make mistakes, just that its reliability is mostly about context. Perhaps what we need then isn't to pick sides in some imaginary battle between intuition and analysis, but to see them as teammates with complementary skills, and our role as the leader coordinating them. And key to that is training our intuition in a new skill, the ability to recognize when it's out of its depth. Situations in which its lightning-fast judgments will confidently lead us in the wrong direction. Ultimately, neither blind faith in intuition nor blanket dependence on analysis will serve us best. Instead, we need disciplined intuition and occasionally a gut feeling that it's time to use your head.